The first thing I like to do is adjust your neck. I'm going to just place my hands right on your neck. Keeping the brain from using up neurotransmitters like serotonin, dopamine, and GABA, and that can help to reduce anxiety. So this is a very good choice for treating hormonal variations. This video is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where you can take classes on photography, illustration, graphic design, freelancing, or business skill development. I like to use Skillshare as personal development as a way to nurture my career. I took a class on 1930s cartoon character designs. I always loved classic cartoons and have gotten ASMR from watching them. I found it so relaxing and inspiring and meditative to just create something so fresh and so new to me. My kids created unique original cartoons after taking this course, and I was so impressed. Some of the classes that I find very interesting, and I cannot wait to take are the essential oil classes. What's great about it is that it's ad-free, so you can stay in the zone while you're exploring new things. There's new classes launched each and every week, so there's always something new to discover. So the first 1,000 people who use the link in the description will get one totally free month on Skillshare, unlimited access to all their classes for free for 1 month. Thank you so much, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video. I hope you enjoy it.
Wonderful. So if you look here at this face mapping chart, this is based on traditional Chinese medicine. And according to TCM, your face is divided up into different sections that correspond with major organs. And your face is actually a reflection of the state of your health. Yes. So I'm going to examine all of these different zones. Will tell me how your heart is doing, how your liver is doing, how your kidneys are doing, how your stomach is doing, as well as your bladder, kidney, and adrenal gland. Okay. So I'm going to use this sort of as a guide and allow you to follow me. Okay. I'm going to start with your forehead. I'm going to be focusing on the liver region first, okay? I'm just going to use my thumb to sort of push on the skin a little bit. Just checking for any kind of I'm going to be looking at your bladder region now. Bladder, up here. And then right in the center, your small intestine. So, just sit still, let me. Just gently tap on this. Okay. I don't see. I'll use this light to help me inspect your nose, okay? I'm just gonna shine this light right starting up here and just scanning the skin on your nose. Scanning the skin. Okay. I'm gonna look underneath your eyes. And I'm just gonna be checking for any creases or any puffiness, anything like that. Could be an indicator of kidney troubles or lack of chi in the liver as well. So let me just start on this side. I'm gonna take some notes on this, okay? And then I'll explain everything that I've noticed and observed, okay? I looked at this part of your face, which corresponds with your liver right here. And I did notice very small little pimples. But it can be an indicator of liver qi deficiency. Yes. Which is treatable. And I took a look at the lower part of your cheek. And there's a little bit of dryness right there. On this section there. So this can be an indicator of lung qi deficiency, which can be caused by sadness. Yes. And right here above your lips, I checked for your spleen health, and I did find a little bit of red spots there. And this can be an indicator of worry, and that can show up on the spleen area and actually affect your spleen. Yes, and I also checked your chin area, specifically found a little bit of acne near the kidney region, and this can be related to fear right here in your chin. So there's some fear, there's some worry, there's some sadness, and perhaps some. Organs can become deficient in energy because of these emotions. They can actually block off energy to these organs. But the good news is that I can help you unblock some of these energy channels through chiropractics. Yes. So I will be completely examining your posture and checking for regions where you hold your stress, where you might be holding some of these emotions. Just stand as natural as you can, okay? I'm gonna be examining your shoulders first, because we tend to hold worry on our shoulders. So I'm gonna be looking at your posture. So just stand naturally. I'm just checking and the way you hold your head and your shoulders. Okay. They're slightly up. You can see that they're slightly risen up. This could be from neck tightness. It's gonna press on your neck. Feel the muscles. I'm just examining the trapezius muscle, as well as the levator scapula, which is underneath. So I'm going to take two fingers and press underneath the trapezius muscle, just to get a feel for the levator scapula. Muscle is pulling your shoulders up. Okay, I'm gonna have to make an adjustment for your neck right there. Okay. And I'm gonna check this side as well. Trapezius muscle, which goes all the way up, as well as the levator scapula, which is tucked underneath. I'm going to check behind your neck. You have some muscles back here that go all the way up to the base of your skull. And those are your occipital muscles. I'm just going to feel around with my fingers at the base of your skull and press. This may actually feel really nice and give you some relief. But it's also part of the examination, actually. Okay. Feel that. Just pressing back here firmly, deliberately. There's just relax your arm. First thing I like to do is adjust your neck. I'm going to just place my hands right on your neck, and I will be supporting your head, okay? And I'll just be guiding you. So you just have to relax and allow me to adjust you, okay? So you can go ahead. Breathe normally until I ask you to take a deep breath in, okay? And then I'll make my adjustment to your left. I'm gonna go that way. Okay. So placing my hands, getting them ready. Okay. And take a nice deep breath, inhale. Your shoulders should feel like they have a little more room. Okay. Good. Just keep the shoulder down. Just keep the shoulder down. Let go of any worries or any stress you're holding on to in your shoulders. Just let that go. Okay. All of that stress and worries just shoulders. Place both my hands top of your shoulders. And you're just gonna stand normally. And I'm going to push down at the same time. And you're gonna feel a nice crack, okay? And this will just help to keep okay. to make an adjustment for your cervical spine. So what I'm going to do is place one hand behind your neck. The other one's going to hold your chin. And I'm going to turn your head slightly up towards the ceiling. Okay. And this will help free up those suboccipital muscles. I'm going to take hold of your right arm.
Thank you.
I'm going to place my right hand underneath your right underarm. And I'll be supporting your hand with my wrist. And just wrap my hands around you. Good. I'm going to make rest on my wrist, and my fingers will wrap around and support you. Okay. So just go ahead and take a nice deep breath. Inhale. Exhale. Perfect. Very good. Okay. That's all just melting right down your arms and through the fingertips. changes from here. Essential oils are essentially plant-based medicine. They are very potent and should not be taken lightly. You may be unaware of some allergies to the herbs, so it's very important to dry out very small amounts first. The first essential oil I'm going to recommend for you is called St. John's Wort. And St. John's Wort actually helps to improve mild moderate depression. It's an ancient remedy used in traditional Chinese medicine to treat mood disorders. It has been studied extensively. This can actually help by keeping the brain from using up neurotransmitters like serotonin, dopamine, and GABA, and norepinephrine as well. I'm going to just give you a small little vial. You can just try this yourself by squeezing a few drops underneath your tongue, or you can even place it in your juice, tea, or just water if you like. St. John's Wort can have antidepressant feel on the brain. It can interfere and also interact with other medications, so you have to be very careful not to mix it with any medications. I'm just going to give you this small amount so you can try it. And this will also help to regulate your mood, which is important for treating depression. So I'm going to put this small vial aside. Remedy I'd like to introduce you to. Ginkgo seeds are used to open channels of energy to different organ systems, including the kidneys, the liver, the brain, and the it's very high in antioxidants, and that can help to reduce anxiety. going to place some in here for you. Just crush a little bit of it. Ginkgo biloba can enhance brain function by increasing mental performance. It can improve your memory, your focus, your attention span. It's used to treat depression. It has anti-inflammatory properties, which improve the body's ability to cope with stress hormones when they are high. I'm going to set this aside for you. So that's wonderful. Ashwagandha. Helps to balance stress and hormone levels. It's actually seen as an adaptogenic, which means when stress is too high, it helps to lower it. When some of your hormones are too low, it'll help to raise it back up. So this is a very good choice for treating hormonal variations that occur with anxiety. Ashwagandha can help to actually reduce cortisol levels. Ashwagandha may also improve your memory, your reaction time, and your ability to perform tasks, making it a wonderful remedy. Brain fog. So, I'm going to give you a small vial, and you can just add some to your food or make it like is pretty fine, so you can use a tea sieve that's lined with a coffee filter, and that should filter out everything for drinking. See if it's helping you with stress and anxiety, okay? Sweat. session.